I would like to call the Forsyth County Planning Commission May 22nd, 2013 meeting to order at 6:30 p.m. Commissioner Iglesias will lead us with the Pledge of Allegiance. Amend and adopt the agenda. Are there any changes to the agenda? If there are no changes, may I have a motion to adopt the agenda for the May 28th, 2013 Forsyth County Planning Commission regular meeting as presented?
So moved.
All those in favor of adopting the agenda, please signify by raising your hand. All opposed, please signify by raising your hand. The motion passes 5-0 for adopting the agenda for the May 28, 2013 Forsyth County Planning Commission regular meeting. Number four, 88 Dave's Creek, LLC, ZA3623, Commission District 3 and Commission District 5. Ms. Bernstein-Goldman.
This is a request to rezone from agricultural A1 to multifamily residential Res 6 on 83.68 acres for 378 attached residential homes with a density of 4.52 units per acre. This property is located on the north side of Dave's Creek Drive across from Dave's Creek Lane. Staff is non-supportive.
I make a motion to open the public hearing for 88 Dave's Creek, LLC, ZA3623. May I have a second?
Second.
All in favor of opening the public hearing on ZA3623, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Motion to open the public hearing on ZA3623 passes 5-0. Is there anyone wishing to speak in favor of 88 Dave's Creek, LLC, ZA3623?
Madam Chair, I'm Emory Lipscomb. I'm here on behalf of 88 Dave's Creek, LLC. This has been discussed for the last month or so as to the zoning district which has been applied for, which is a Res 6 zoning district, and as to the density which was applied for, which was 4.52 units per acre, a total of 378 units. And we received many suggestions that this was the wrong zoning district and this was the wrong number of units. And over the past month, there have been numerous meetings with our clients, with the Planning Commission member, Craig Nolen, with Commissioner Todd Levent. I've had discussions with various of the commissioners and various of the Planning Commission members myself, and it became very apparent that there was a great number of people who were very much dissatisfied with the zoning as it was proposed. Accordingly, we would ask if you would entertain an alternative to this, which would be a Res 4 zoning rather than a Res 6, with a density which would be 3.2 rather than 4.52 for a number of units of 267 rather than 378 for a reduction of 111 units. And rather than waste your time and the time of those who are here, that's what we would like for you to consider if you're so inclined. We would appreciate it if you would allow us to present you with an alternative to what has been originally filed.
Thank you.
Thank you. Glad to go forward with that if that is acceptable.
May I ask a question for this one? Do you have a sketch plat?
Yes,
with
we do.
Your new
Yes, we do. We'd be glad to put that on the screen.
I'd like to see that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Can you do that? We also have some revised proposed zoning conditions which would reflect the alternative that I've just presented briefly to you and would like to go over in more detail. This is the revised site plan, which is for a Res 4, and is for the 267 homes, which will all be detached homes. Previously, we were proposing some attached and some detached. These are all detached homes. Had a chance to look at that.
Yeah.
All right, sir.
Thank you, Emory.
Again, what we're proposing is that the property be rezoned Res 4 with no more than 3.2 homes per acre with a total not to exceed 267 homes. Beyond that, we're proposing that these all be detached homes and that they have not less than 2,200 square feet of heated floor space, exclusive of garages and basements, and that the site plan, which you are looking at, would be the site plan for the development. Glad to answer any questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lipscomb. Is there anyone else who'd like to speak in favor of ZA3623? Is there anyone who'd like to speak in opposition of ZA3623 88 Dave's Creek LLC? Did you give your form?
Yes.
And
yes.
Would you state your name, please?
Tom Stocks, like Stocks and Bonds. I live in Newgate, the townhome community. I came to address a townhome arrangement, not monopoly houses. So I don't know about this, but what I'm concerned about living in South Forsyth County is that we have some sort of beacon or banner to use as a guideline of what to build around there. Like Whelan came in and built around Windermere. They looked at the Windermere homes and they built like Windermere. The only thing that I suggest is that something needs to be done as a comparative basis. If it was going to be townhomes, then Newgate should be the townhome, just like they built in Vickery, the exact same types of things, as a guideline. Nothing less should be done. This is the only thing that I'm concerned about. I am not against development. I mean, you can't hold that back. I mean, I just want to make sure that the county maintains its level as it does in the southeastern United States right now. And so this is I would have to be considered by a public presentation. So
thank you very much.
Good evening, Mrs. Chairman. My name is Gabrielle Pohlmeier. I have a couple of questions. This is a total new concept. Is it legal to be discussed here? Don't they have to reapply?
If I can, it's kind of a hybrid situation. If the applicant is formally presented a change, the significant change, it would be a problem. This Planning Commission has the power to adopt a less intense district. You have been presented with that option by the applicant, and that's somewhat of the rules aren't entirely clear as to how that would be handled. You would, in theory, have the power to do that. In theory, they should.
Sir, I got the question for you. You used one word. Just to clarify, you said significant changes, right?
And let me address the council. Probably the better process would have been to present the new plan pursuant to the procedures for a change in the plan, but they have just simply asked the board to consider complying with their power to adopt a less intense district. You have the authority to adopt a less intense district.
Because this is less intense, we can hear this.
That's correct.
Madam Chairman.
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion that we add 10 minutes to each side, since we've had a little discussion here and there's probably more people that want to talk and just add an extra 10 minutes to each side.
What's the pleasure of the board?
Is
there a second?
Yes, sir.
That was a motion. Motion to extend the time 10 minutes for each side.
Second.
All those in favor, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Motion to extend the time for both sides by 10 minutes. Passes 5-0. So Mr. Fricke, you're finished, right? So you can start the time back, please. Ma'am?
Okay. I also would request that we stop in between us changing speakers. That we stop the time between us changing.
You mean walking to and from your...
Yes, ma'am. Okay, so are we now discussing 267 freestanding homes? Is that correct? Or are we still discussing the old plan?
The 267 is what the discussion is.
In which case, I would like to give you to consider from Vicky Lane entrance to Old Atlanta is exactly half a mile of winding road. It's a country lane. It's a pretty country lane. This development, even though it has been modified somewhat, has one entrance, which is also the exit. Conservatively estimated, it will add another 600 cars at high traffic hours to Vicky Lane, which means it'll take you 2 hours to get out. And if they say, oh, it's only 267 units, well, at the moment, most people that I asked have 2 to 3 cars in their garage. One kid drives, mother drives, father drives, and I'm only saying it's about 600 cars added. Furthermore, there is no talk about now or then about any landscaping bordering all the properties on Vicky Lane, and it goes right around in a circle. No fences, no privacy fences. All the trees are going to be cut down. The noise which the Vicky Lane people will have to endure with from the quarry, for example, is going to be really bad, not to mention the people who are going to buy these houses. So I think this whole venture needs to go back somewhere and be thought out a bit more carefully of what it actually does to people. So far, South Forsyth has been a very nice place to live. I have come from Germany 17 years ago. I have lived in Forsyth County 14 years. I have come from a very high density Cologne, West Germany place, and I'm seeing this duplicated now here. Do we really want to have Germany here? Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else wish? Yes.
Before going forward, I just want to make clear that previous discussion that I had and the question that was directed to you, this board is formally considering the original application. You've been presented with an option which you may or may not choose to include in your consideration, which is the reduced numbers that were presented.
So if a motion is made when this is over, that's when it would be stated that
It's different. It's going to be changes. Different from the application.
Okay, I understand that. Does everybody understand that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Anyone else wishing to speak in opposition? Yes. And did you fill your form out?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you very much. Thank you. State your name first, please.
Yes, my name is George Aubrey. I live in the Windermere subdivision. And even with the extra time, I know there's a lot of people here tonight that are not supportive of this plan. I would just ask if we could see a show of hands of all those who are not supportive of this plan. Thank you.
Either.
With either.
Either of them.
I also have some petitions here that I'll be happy to supply of about 115 residents in Windermere who are opposed to any high residential zoning at all and are requesting that this land be zoned in accordance to the surrounding area, which Res 3 would be more appropriate. There's a tremendous amount of traffic on Dave's Creek already, and there's a subdivision that's going in with Wyland Homes, and the immense amount of traffic that we put onto Vicky Lane or put onto Dave's Creek with even a Res 4 would make significant commute times for the individuals trying to get out to Old Atlanta Road. Dave's Creek dead ends at each end onto a two-lane road, and it's a two-lane winding road, and is really not able to support the kind of traffic that this residence would generate.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Madam Chairman, may I ask a question? This is Jim Boff over here. Sorry. My question is that this new plan, if you decide one way or another on it, will be, as I understand it, without benefit of knowing whether staff is supportive or not.
That's true.
I have a question for staff regarding that. Is are there any sort of performance standards that get reduced going from Res 6 to Res 4? Like, do any of the buffers get reduced or anything like that?
There are different performance standards. That's correct.
Anyone else wish to speak in opposition? And did you do your form? Thank you, and state your name first, please.
My name is Suzanne Chapman. I've lived in this county for about 12 years. I'm a former high school teacher. I taught at South Forsyth High School and several others in Fulton County. The reason why we moved out here is because coming from Gwinnett, everything was very congested. It was tough to get in and out of places that you needed to. Currently, I live on Avalon Court, which directly backs up to this new subdivision. I have about a half acre, and there's a tiny bit of buffer that would be remaining if they went ahead and made the townhomes as the application states right now. Getting out in the mornings, I leave, you know, with kids about 7:15, and it's pretty easy getting on, you know, old it's easy getting to Old Atlanta, but when you get to Old Atlanta, that's where the trouble starts. You have people coming from the other side, and there's no stopping. You have to just get through and hope that the person coming along the road isn't going to hit you. It's a very dangerous spot. There's no light. There never has been a light. And it's the same thing in the afternoon. If we need to get out and, you know, people are coming home from work, it's also a dangerous situation. It's hard to get in and off. And my concern is that, you know, there is just one entrance and one exit from this new subdivision, and that would just compound the troubles that we have every day. And I don't think that the people in my area would appreciate the home values going down because of these smaller homes. We all bought, most of us, from Windermere, and they're nice homes. We've kept them up. And anything that you build in that's going to be a townhome is definitely going to bring down the property values of our homes. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else wishing to speak in opposition?
I am Modell Hay. I live at 2154 Vicky Lane. My husband's here with me, John. This is essentially a bait and switch. The developer and his attorney have had the time to develop an entire new site plan, but has not shared it with the community in advance. I would request that the developer reapply. If that's not necessary, I would suggest that they just at least re-advertise and give us the opportunity to see the product they're presenting. From what I'm hearing, we're looking now at detached townhomes. It's the same square footage. Before, he said the attached townhomes would be 2,200 square foot. Now we're looking at detached 2,200 square foot townhomes, essentially. And I would request that you take a look at that. Also, I know that last night I emailed you all some stream analysis reports and topo reports. I'd request that that get taken into consideration as well, and people review that from the county. But I would ask that, you know, that we start all over again. Please.
Thank you. Anyone else?
Who does that go to?
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. State your name first, please.
Thank you. My name's John Burt. I live in Windermere. I grew up in Dunwoody, moved to Forsyth County from Gwinnett County to get away from the mess. And there's so many of us here who love Forsyth. It's such a special place. I wanted to tell you all that I own a lot of real estate. I've worked hard all my life. And I say that because all of us have worked hard. We bought a certain vision, a picture, something we love for our families. And it's so exciting to live where we all love. And I know that none of us here want to see any drastic changes, and that what's warranted here are some studies. My three kids go to school right there at Haw Creek and Lakeside, and you know, it's a great environment, but the classes are packed. Okay, the Windermere Parkway, the Trammell, I mean, we don't know about the traffic, we don't know about what kind of values are we building here. Are we building 300, 400, 500? I paid 600. You know, it needs to be, it's kind of like what they're doing in Milton. Milton is always going to remain strong because they're at a really great level there.
Sir, hold on a second while I reset the clock.
Okay, sorry.
Okay, go ahead.
And I say all that because we are in a high demand area. I've got a buddy of mine who's a developer. He called me up about 3 months ago. He said, John, you know what's hot? Where you are. They want to be there. So we don't have to take anything. And I just encourage us all to realize we're in a really great area.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anyone else?
Hi, thank you. I'm Kristen Lehman. I'm new to Forsyth. I moved here August last year because, like him, I had the vision for my kids wanting to live in a rural setting, not having to deal with the traffic and the overcrowding. I have some concerns that have slightly been addressed, and it's mainly on the schools. And I keep seeing all these residential developments being built and being in our area. Traffic is a major concern. You can't get anywhere in South Forsyth. But the main concern for me is to hear that our schools are overcrowded. And when the Georgia Commission, the Georgia Education says that the maximum size a classroom should be for kindergarten to third grade is 21 kids per class. And they hear that a first grade class, several of them in South Forsyth have 31 kids in their class. There is no money coming in for new teachers. There's no money coming in for new schools, but we're building all these new developments and there's nowhere to put these kids. And I just don't want that our kids to be forsaken in their education just because we keep developing and developing and developing. I want us to look and say, are we doing smart growth? Are we talking to Fulton County? Are we talking to Gwinnett? Are we talking to our brothers and sisters there and seeing the lessons learned that they had when they had growth? And I'm sure we are. Are we looking beyond and talking to the Forsyth County School Board to see how, when we approve all these different residents, is this going to affect our schools? I want my kids to go here all the way to high school. I'm hoping that we can stay here, but I cannot risk my children's education for them to have 31 to 35 kids in their classroom. No one can learn with that. So we need to make sure that we are looking at this growth, we're being smart, we're addressing it effectively. We all want to see this county be successful. We want to have growth, but we want to have smart growth and make sure as we're approving these that we're looking at how it's affect in everything in our county. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Did you hand in your form?
Yes, they have my form. My name is Swede Nelson. My wife and I actually live on Vicky Lane. I'm a business owner, lived in this county for 13 years, came from Alpharetta. We moved into Windermere, spent 12 years there before moving to Vicky Lane this past year. We moved to this county because it's a beautiful place to live. What we don't see on this, you've got the road there, Dave's Creek, it looks like a straight road. When I come out of Vicky Lane, I'm right now, it's a traffic jam, and it's hard for me to see the cars coming and going. If you had all those other cars right up the street from me, it's just a nightmare. When I go to turn out there, I've almost got hit several times. So we need to address the traffic issue. I like the area of what the previous lady mentioned about smart growth and quality growth. This is a beautiful neighborhood, this whole section right here. However, if you start tearing down all those trees, I know the quarry's been there before we were, and but we've got to be careful about the noise that will continue to go down through that valley. I lived right down the street there in Windermere, which we used to hear the noise coming from the quarry. I hear it now. You tear those trees down, you're really going to have a noise problem, not only for us, but for all those new people moving in. So I would just address the traffic issue, the noise issue, the value of these homes. We all want to keep our value up in this area. And there's 80 homes being developed across the street. Down the street, there will be, I'm sure they'll be adding some more homes. We just have to be careful what we're doing here so that we continue to have a great community that we have here in Forsyth. Thank you.
Anyone else? No one else. You have 6 minutes. Thank you. I must be the form Gestapo or something.
Hi, my name is Paul Taylor. I live in Windermere. And I feel like what just happened here tonight was I had gone to a surgeon and was told that I was going to lose my leg from the hip down, and when I go to get my leg removed, the surgeon says, I got great news, you're going to lose it from the knee down. I think it's imperative that you make the applicant reapply so the communities and neighbors surrounding Windermere can put together a thoughtful plan, analyze it, and come back with a comprehensive report on how they feel about the development.
Thank you, Mr. Taylor.
Hi, I'm Dr. Brent Carroll. I live on 2140 Vicky Lane. I think I'm speaking for everyone here when we just say, this is not a good move. This is not a good place to put this kind of density. I also want to say that I agree that the bait and switch has been done. This fellow here, Brett, he lied at the first community meeting multiple times. We caught him in lies. What they've done tonight is essentially lying. They come here and switch it for us. This man cannot be trusted. I don't trust him to build anything in my neighborhood. I don't trust a word that comes out of this guy's mouth. I mean, he has lied multiple times to us. That being said, I mean, I understand we can't stop growth there, and he should be able to build something that's Res 3, like the area. That's fine. But, I mean, I can't add anything else to what everybody has said, except that I don't feel like this whole process has been very trustworthy from this group. Thank you.
But Res 3 is acceptable for you?
No.
Density, we've got to look at the density. 1.92 across the street.
Here's the other issue, is it is a very dangerous intersection there. So you build this thing, and some kid gets killed coming out of Vicky Lane onto Old Atlanta. That's on everybody's head here. And that's going to be a lawsuit. There's going to be some trouble unless a lot is done. And that is going to happen. That is, you cannot see. It is downhill, sloping down. It's hard coming out of Vicky Lane as well. The road is windy. It has trees everywhere. This is not even close to what it's like. So somebody's going to die if you.
Thank you very much. Anyone else? You have 4 minutes and 13 seconds.
I'm just going to be brief. I live in Arden Greens, which is the nearest subdivision.
And your name, ma'am?
Kathleen Waller, which is the nearest subdivision with Bennington in Windermere to this proposed development. As has been mentioned, Ryland is already in the process of adding, I'm sorry, I don't know the number, 100 homes perhaps. Again, multiplied by the number of cars, 2 to 3 per home. You want to add that across the street even at the reduced density. You just have 400 to 500 cars additional per day on a curved road, which does not show on their diagram. It is a curved road ending in a dead end. Thank you.
Did you hand your form in?
What form? My name?
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Anyone else? You can fill it out. We'll wait for you to fill it out. We'll stop the clock and wait for you to fill it out. Excuse me, I didn't hear that. I'm sorry.
My name is Stephen Hamill. I just bought the resident at 1811, which is beside the entranceway right there on Davis Creek. I have 5 girls, and my problem is the traffic, you know, and my kids playing outside. You know, you're dumping out probably close to, if you build 267 homes, probably close to 1,000 cars a day. With people visiting, friends. My concern is just there's only one entrance way. I haven't had time because I just bought the residence and really hadn't had time. I only got one thing in the mail about the whole development. And I just asked for the traffic on Old Atlanta. It just needs to be very planned out, and concerns with all the community. You know, you got standards. You know, you come in and you build something that's lower, your value of your property just goes completely down. But my number one concern is my kids. and their safety and their education. And I've been in Forsyth County for 11 years. I own a residence at Pilgrim Mill Road. And it's just, I think there's more study, and I think they should be, they're trying to change it. I think they should be reapply for a new application. You know, it's just a bait and switch. That's the way I see it. And I'll let somebody else speak.
Thank you, Mr. Hamill. Anyone else? Mr. Lipscomb, would you like to speak to some of the concerns the residents have?
Yes, thank you.
Hold on a second.
All right. Okay. Thank you. Let's set the stage here for what we're really here about tonight. It is a consideration of 88 Dave's Creek's proposed zoning, and we have laid out an alternative to you, which reduces the density by 111 units. So we submit to you that that is a significant decrease. We want you to keep in mind that this property that we're proposing to zone, which is 83.68 acres, has as its border on three sides, the west side, the north side, and the east side, a large rock quarry, the largest rock quarry operating in this county. And so we submit to you that that has a significant effect on this property. What would be the other uses of this property other than the density that we are proposing to you tonight? Would it be to increase the size of the rock quarry? Would it be to add M1 zoning there for uses which would complement the rock quarry? I don't think so. That wouldn't be a proper use of this property. Residential is a good use, and it complements the neighborhood there. These are all detached units that we're proposing. Now you say, well, we need to study this some more. Well, you've got an engineering review of our proposal. You have the water and sewer review of our initial proposal. The planning department has considered our initial proposal. So I say to you that you've had your professional staff review the proposal that you have before you, and that would also cover this alternative proposal, because this is less than what you have before you. So I don't think you need any more studies for you to make a decision on what is before you, either as the original proposal or as the alternative proposal. There is nothing that has been found by the engineering department that raises an impossibility of safe traffic for the original proposal. So,
please. Go ahead, Mr. Lipscomb.
Thank you. There is nothing that's been raised by the Water and Sewer Department that indicates that this property cannot operate in accordance with the county's water and sewer requirements. There is nothing that has been raised by the Planning Department that says that this cannot be developed as a residential community. So you have before you a proposal which can be approved, which doesn't need to be restudied, and is for the same type of uses, except you don't have detached homes here. You don't have attached homes here. You have only detached homes. And we submit to you that this can be considered tonight, that the obvious decision would be to approve 111 home decrease that does not contain any attached homes. And that's what we request you do. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lipscomb. So, the opposition has 2 minutes.
202.
In terms of the density...
Excuse me, your name one more time.
George Aubrey.
Thank you.
Okay. In terms of the density, we're talking 3.2 units per acre with the Res 4. A lot of the surrounding communities are 1.9, so the density is still significant higher than what the surrounding communities are. In regards to the mining, it is surrounded on three sides, but one side is zoned M1 and they're not able to mine there. That's for office structures, so that's not going to be a mining operation. The other thing I would say too, that according to the property tax records, this land was sold in December of 2012, and I think the quarry was there in December of 2012. And I'll yield my time to anybody else who wants to speak for the opposition.
Thank you, Mr. Aubrey.
I have my paper. I'm Gabrielle Pollmeyer, and I have a question. Is it normal in the United States that one proposal has been discussed and not viewed favorably, as the lady over there said, and then something else is shoved under the door to give you the impression that this is a good deal, taking the second proposal? I don't get it. Is this normal? I mean, I was under the impression that in Forsyth County, as in the other counties in the United States, in Georgia, something has to follow proper procedure. Now, the proper procedure, as far as I can see, correct me if I'm wrong, would have been for them to propose, okay, the residents don't like it, the county probably doesn't like Res 3 with 1,000, 1,500 additional cars thrown on a little country lane. Then, okay, we propose something else here, you know the people you work for who said, no, we don't view the Res 6 favorably. Look at this one. Do you like this favorably better? So I'm wondering, is this shoved under the door to make you look at it? Oh, well, they're building 111 houses less. Well, that's great. So we can approve this. I don't get it. Sorry.
I'll answer your question.
Thank you.
That happens all the time, and that's why we're here.
Okay.
Is to buffer that.
Okay, yeah, I knew that.
Thank you. I make a motion to close the public hearing on 88 Davis Creek, LLC, ZA3623. Do I have a second?
Second.
All those in favor of closing the public hearing on 88 Davis Creek, LLC, ZA3623, please signify by raising your hand. All opposed? Motion passes 5-0 to close the public hearing. Commissioner Nolen and Commissioner Moses, since this is in District 3 and District 5, have you two discussed with each other who be making a motion on this?
Yes, we have, and I'll make a motion to recommend to the Board of Commissioners that ZA3623 be rezoned from agricultural A1 to Res 3 on 83.68 acres for residential homes with a density of 2.2 units per acre. This with a minimum square feet of 2,200 square feet of heated floor space, exclusive of garages and basements. This is due to the negative impact on the surrounding homes, which have a lower density zoning, and due to the traffic congestion that already exists in this area. In addition, I would like to recommend that 88 Daves Creek provide the Board of Commissioners with a sketch plat for the Res 3 zoning. That's my motion.
I'll second for discussion.
We have a motion and we have a second for
Madam
discussion.
Chairman?
Yes.
I did not hear a discussion of the staff
conditions to the extent they are eventually considered, as with the previous application, the engineering condition number two would be unnecessary.
No traffic study. Condition number two.
The condition which says no traffic study will be required unless recommended improvements are not incorporated into construction plans is not a zoning condition such that it does not need to, the condition does not need to be included.
Okay. So would Commissioner Moses need to restate his motion?
In all honesty, I don't believe he mentioned any of the conditions, staff conditions.
No, I didn't.
Did you do that intentionally?
Well, I did, but if it's a concern, you know, we can discuss it.
Okay. We're up for discussion.
I'm open to changing my motion, you know, if depending on the outcome of the discussion.
Commissioner Neal?
I was just curious if the applicant is okay with Res 3 zoning. I mean, I know that the request is for four. There's a motion. If that passes, then that would then rezone that to Res 3.
Thank you for asking the question. As you know, the Res 3 will currently not allow you to get anywhere close to 3 units to the acre, and the motion is 2.2 homes to the acre is what I heard. And we're asking for 3.2, which is a great reduction, and we would appreciate your consideration of that reduction that we've offered. Thank you.
My answer to that is it's not a reduction because it's starting off as A1.
Yeah, I was going to say. I mean, would that
that's
be
not a reduction
over A1 though? My question was, is that desirable over A1? Just because if that motion didn't pass, then that property going back to, you know, if it passed at Res 3, that changes the value of that land. And if it's not developable at Res 3, then that affects that taxable or the taxes on that land.
In other words, can you accept a Res 3, Emory?
No, our request is for the Res 4 with a 3.2 density.
Okay,
thank you.
So we have a motion and we have a second.
Do I need to add these conditions?
Only if you intend them to be on there.
The Board of Commissioners can add all the conditions they want. Okay, so I don't need to add any conditions. I'm just trying to get through what I can get, you know, I've heard the residents surrounding the area, and I would hope that this commission would join with me in listening to the residents who are there and vote with me on this.
We have a motion and a second, so we need to vote. All those in favor of the motion on ZA 3623 88 Daves Creek LLC, please signify by raising your hand. All those opposed, please signify by raising your hand. Motion fails 3-2. Commissioner Iglesias, Commissioner Nolen, and Commissioner Bowman voting no.
Need a new motion.
We could have a new motion.
Yes, the motion to approve under those conditions
failed.
So the floor is now open for a new motion.
Okay. The floor, anyone have a new motion on ZA 3623?
Madam Chairman, I'll make a motion. I'll make a recommendation that ZA 3623 be sent to the commissioners for approval for a Res 4 with a 3.2 density. with staff conditions, with staff conditions as noted.
May I have a second? I'll second that. Is there any discussion from the board?
Would you accept less density than the 3.2?
No.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor of the motion for 88 Daves Creek, ZA 3623, please signify by raising your hand. All those opposed, please raise your hand.
I'll make another
Please
motion.
Please have respect.
I'll make Please. Another motion. I'll make another motion.
Wait a minute, just a minute for me. Okay. I need to say that the motion failed. 3-2 again, I believe, was it? All right, now we can open the floor to another motion. Okay. Is that correct, Mr. Fricke?
I believe that, yes, that's correct. It failed with 2 votes in favor, 3 votes opposed. And it was Moses, Iglesias, and Neal that were opposed. Thank you.
Okay, I'll make another motion. Let me think about it for a second. I would like to make a motion to recommend to the Board of Commissioners that ZA3623 be rezoned from agricultural A1 to Res 3 on 83.68 acres for residential homes with a density of 2.2 units per acre. Without 88 Daves Creek providing the Board of Commissioners with a sketch plat for Res 3.
Dr. Moses,
that's essentially the same motion I made, but it is different.
I just, when you said without providing a sketch plat, are you saying there? Is that the difference between your motion?
Let me just leave that section off to keep it, make it a different motion. Okay. It was seconded being more restrictive. I'm hoping that I'll get another second with it being less restrictive. And let me just delete what I said about not needing a sketch plat, but just leaving that section off, and that makes the motion different.
So is the motion to
maybe that'll be palatable to the commission?
Is the motion to approve Res 3 with 2.2 units per acre? Is that the extent
with,
of it?
Oh yeah, and with a minimum square feet of 2,200 heated floor space, exclusive of garages and basements.
I understand. Thank you.
I'm hoping to get another second.
That was staff conditions or any conditions at all, or just exactly
well,
what
if you
said.
Want to put some conditions no. on there,
Will you
I'm open.
Just state the motion.
Oh, again?
Just the motion, again, please,
okay.
for me.
I'll just state the motion, and it is different than what I did. excuse me. Motion to recommend to the Board of Commissioners that ZA3623 be rezoned from agricultural A1 to Res 3 on 83.68 acres for residential homes with a density of 2.2 units per acre and with a minimum, the home should have a minimum of 2,200 square feet of heated floor space, exclusive garage and basements.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Is there a second? Motion fails for lack of a second. Anyone want to make a stab at another motion on ZA 3623?
I'll make another motion. I make a motion that we postpone making a decision until our next public regular meeting.
Second that for discussion.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion?
I mean, that would give staff the opportunity to look over the plan. I know that it's downzoning, but the original plan wasn't considered consistent with the comprehensive land plan. So, you know, reevaluating it, staff, to see if staff is supportive of the revised plan is not entirely a bad idea. And I know that that may adversely affect the entire schedule. And I don't know if we could zone, I would ask staff if this was able to be zoned as res 4 with 2.5 units to the acre as a stipulation, that allows them to keep smaller, you know, less road frontage per lot, so they may be able to buffer more against that mining area, look at trying to leave more open space on the backside. But that's getting it down to the res 3, so it seems like that kind of is in conformance with the intent of the land use plan.
And also, I don't, it's my belief that Dave's Creek 88 is not beating the door down to get this done in a hurry. From what, you know, so I don't see a problem with postponing.
So we have a motion to postpone, don't we?
Yes.
And a second?
Before we vote on that.
Yes.
Keep in mind, this Res 4 concept has not been submitted, so the staff won't have anything to review. We won't come back with a new review next month. We'll come back with the same product you saw tonight. All you heard from an applicant was a willingness to be reduced by an action.
Well, let me amend my motion then to include a submittal by the by the applicant of
you have to have the second taken back first. Oh, yeah. If he's gonna,
I'm not sure I want to do that. I just want to postpone it. I'm gonna keep it clean and simple.
I mean, postponing it would behoove the applicant to provide it to staff, but now staff wouldn't re-review that.
No, but the applicant could still provide us with any more information, or if they so choose.
I'm not convinced the staff would accept that application.
That's your business. Okay, thank you, Tom. So my motion stands, and it's been seconded, and I'm hoping that the commission will agree on that motion to postpone. What?
Well, I mean, if we postponed it, the idea would be that staff could provide feedback, but I understand that staff won't. Right.
It'll give us more time to think about it, because this was, I wasn't prepared for Res 4 tonight. I was prepared for Res 6. So it would give us time to go over it. This is about
so
us.
We have a motion to postpone, and we have a second.
Yes. And it would give us time to go over this among ourselves through the five of us and start off with a clean slate next month.
I mean, the other suggestion I had was going ahead and giving it the density of Res 3, but zoning it as Res 4 so that the lot sizes and the performance standards of Res 4 would exist, except that they would not be able to
do more than 2.2.
So that way it provides for more open space area potentially and less infrastructure. So,
and we could do that next month too. That's something we could discuss. I think it's a reasonable thing, especially since this was just given to us an hour before we met tonight. That I think it's reasonable that we take our time and deliberate on it and think about it, you know, and then come back, because I don't believe that it would hurt anybody for us to take a little time and be a little more thorough with it.
Okay, well, let's bring it to a vote.
Have you
and
got
see
any
what
thoughts?
Happens.
I just want, it will hurt the applicant to postpone it. We would ask you.
People, please. Mr. Fricke, can Commissioner Moses speak with Mr. Lipscomb?
At this point in time, the commission's procedures call for the commission to act on the motion after the public hearing has been closed.
So we just need to vote. We're done.
Correct. And there's a motion and second on the floor. You may discuss amongst yourselves.
No questions can be asked
of the public
to clarify anything.
Your procedures require you to go forward without input.
Okay. Then we need to
Commissioner
vote.
Iglesias, have you got some input? It looks like you may have.
Commissioner Neal was looking like he was going to ask them to resubmit, and I wanted to make sure that I was understanding him correctly when he said no, that was not what he wanted.
Right, that's correct. Yeah, okay. I don't want them to have to start the process over if we're able to continue and revise it to something that's reasonable as part of this application.
Well, that'll give us time to discuss it a little more with the Davis Creek 88 also.
I was just clarifying.
Okay, so let's vote on the motion to postpone ZA 3623. We have a motion and a second. All those in favor of postponing ZA 3623, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Motion carries to postpone ZA 3623, 5-0. May I have a motion for adjournment of the May 28th, 2013 Planning Commission regular meeting?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor of the motion to adjourn, please signify by raising your hand. Any opposed? Motion carries to adjourn 5-0 at 8:49.